161st Street here in the Bronx. MLB The Show's got baseball from Yankee Stadium. Today we've got a good matchup ahead between the New York Mets and the Milwaukee Brewers. It's going to be a premier pitching matchup. Two of the league's hardest throwers go head-to-head next. Striding in is Jonathan Villar, and we are ready for some daytime baseball. The 2-1 home.
He's only four pitches in, but he doesn't look too sharp to start the day off.
And a great location that time on the corner. 3-2 now. Our temperature at first pitch and even 70 degrees here this afternoon. And a fastball swung on and missed, and the leadoff man is gone to open up the ball game. Next to hit, Brandon Nimmo. Lifetime versus this pitcher. He's 2-for-3. Able to protect the plate with two strikes, and he'll see another one. Again, a 1-2. This is popped up. And he'll lunge out of the crouch to make the play for out number two. Next up, Francisco Lindor. Francisco Lindor. 1-1. Swing and a chopper to third. He's got it. And they'll have no play as he reaches first base safely.
Batting fourth, the first baseman.
Stepping in now, Pete Alonso. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. Out of the stretch, the 3-2 pitch home. Line drive, base hit to right. And they won't even attempt to run on that arm in right. So despite the runner moving on the pitch, it'll wind up first and second here. At the plate now, Michael Conforto. And there's ball two now. For his career in this matchup, he's 1-for-3. Fouled off. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. And now, Colton Wong. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. The 1-2. And, oh, he can't get out of the way of that one, so the leadoff man will be on to open the frame. Next for Milwaukee, Willie Adames. Wong gets his lead at first, nobody out. Scorched to third. The second for one. On to first, and they get them both. And here's Christian Yelich now, looking to get on base and keep this first inning alive. The 1-1.
Yeah, Matt, you see the same pitch three times in a row and you find yourself down 1-2 in the count. Your head starts to get on a swivel here. Is he coming back with it four times, or do I have to sit on something else?
A swing and a miss at a sinker. The strikeout retires the side. Inning is over. Now at the plate, Javier Baez. He'll get us started in the top of the second. And he fouls this one off. Pulled the string on him. Strike three swinging. The throw to first is in time. One down. Next, here is Jeff McNeil.
Number six.
The 1-2.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Good eye to lay off the slider there, and he works it to full 3-2 here.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
In there, the base hit. Not in time, and he's in there with a double.
Detective number 33.
the box, James McCann. 2-2 to the Mets catcher. Sent in the air out to straightaway center. Kane is under it. Two down. So now here is Marcus Stroman looking to put them ahead early with this at bat. No score here as we play inning number two. Mets pitcher behind at the plate with a ball and two strikes.
Hey, I know it's the pitcher at the plate, but he's going to grind it out right here. He's got a chance to help himself, and nothing's a bigger backbreaker to a team than watching the pitcher drive in the road.
And he is safe at third as he moves up on what's likely to be ruled a wild pitch. Did well just to make contact there as he spoils off a good changeup. Now the 2-2.
Well, he really needs to make this guy swing the bat right here. He's not the type of hitter you want to dance around with.
Out of the stretch, the 3-2 home. And an off-speed pitch swung on and missed, and with that, the side is retired. Striding forward now, the Brewers cleanup hitter, Avisail Garcia. He's set to lead off the home half of the second. A little too much bite on the breaking ball that time as it's well off the outside. Just off the inside part of the plate, it's 3-1.
Good job to work the count and put himself back in the driver's seat. Started off with one strike, and now he's got the count in his favor, 3-1.
High and deep to center field. Looking up is Nimmo. And goodbye. This one ain't coming back. So now to the plate, Narvaez. And he takes one off the inside corner for ball two. Swing and a line drive. But this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. Late on that one as it's fouled off to the left side. And a check swing here, but the bat clearly breaks the plane as he's set down for the first out. One out, base is empty, and that'll bring up Eduardo Escobar. Trilled to the left side, and that'll just sneak past his outstretched arm, a base hit.
Batting seven, the first baseman, number 20.
In now, Daniel Vogelbach. Down low, two balls and a strike. Here's a breaking ball, but it doesn't quite find the strike zone.
Well, that backdoor breaking ball just missed right there. It's a very effective pitch. If you can hit the outside corner of that pitch, it's unhittable.
Oh, and this ball is absolutely blasted. High and deep and gone right down the line the other way. Wow! Standing in now, Lorenzo Cain. Just hung in there on that one. We'll try again, 1-2. Hard sinker misses, 2-2. Hit hard on the ground to second. Baez has it, and that's the second out. So next to hit is Brandon Woodruff. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. Three runs already home here. On the ground to second for Baez. Reined in. Throw to first with time to spare, and the side is retired. third set to get underway, and the switch hitter Jonathan Villar will be the next to bat.
Hey, Matty, they need to get some offense going in this one. Getting a run back in this inning, give them a little bit of confidence that they can keep up in this game.
Set to deal on a ball and two strikes. And he'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. Chopper to short. Adamez scoops it up. And the throw pulls the first baseman off the bag, and he's safe at first. Next to dig in, Brandon Nimmo, 0-for-1 for him here in this one. And here's a fastball, not close, as he runs it to 2-1 now. He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
I love the approach out on the mound. Everything's down in the zone as it should be, but now you find yourself in a 3-1 count. Do you elevate a little bit more and get back in this zone, or do you just pitch around it?
Next up from New York, Francisco Lindor, as he'll dig into the left-handed batter's box. The 2-1 is swung on and missed, and that's strike two.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
King is to his left as he puts it away in the alley for the first out of the inning. Up next, the power bat of Pete Alonso. And there are runners at the corners now. The 3-2 pitch. Good battle here. This will be the seventh pitch coming up. And it's fouled away. And another foul ball. He's set. Here's the 3-2.
Hey, have an AB right here. I know it's frustrating the heck out of the pitcher. You keep fouling these pitches off, maybe one misses over the heart of the plate.
Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. Catch made in center. Here comes the runner from third. And the run is in to score from third. It's now a 3-1 ball game. Next for the Mets, Michael Conforto. 0-for-1 here in the early going. Here now the 2-2. Line towards center field. And that'll get down for a base hit. At the plate, Javier Baez fouled away. A 1-2. Again, he sends it out of play.
Can we be honest here? That was a terrible pitch. That was right over the heart of the plate. Two strikes on the guy. He is lucky he's getting his pitch back.
2-2 the count. 2-2 now to Baez. And a half-hearted swing there as they tie him up inside for the third strike, and the inning is over. That'll give way to the veteran second baseman, Colton Wong. Chopped in front of home plate. Throws in time, and that's out number one. Next to hit is Willie Adamez. Here's the 1-1 pitch. 1-2 now as that's in there at the knees. And the slider gets him swinging. Two gone. In is Christian Yelich.
Number 22. Christian.
Even at a ball and a strike, here's the pitch. And the cutter got him swinging. Strike three, and the side is retired. New inning set to get underway, and next to bat will be the outfielder, Jeff McNeil. Now the 3-2 pitch is a called strike three on the corner. Now it'll be James McCann. He flew out in his last AB. 3-1 is our score here in inning number four. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Inside for a ball as he falls behind to him here. 3-1.
A 3-1 count, tying run on deck. Good spot to be a hitter right now. You have to look for something middle in.
Again, another foul ball. Another one sent foul. The next 3-2. He is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Next to stand in is Marcus Stroman, trying to avoid becoming the third strikeout victim of the inning here. And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. Now a fastball, but that's easy to lay off, and it's back to even at 2-2.
You certainly know he's not trying to work around.
That will have to press pause as that's strike three to retire the side. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And next it'll be the outfielder, Avisail Garcia. Fouled off. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball. Too high, ball three.
Looked like he tried to elevate a fastball on that 2-2 pitch there, but kind of overdid it. With a pitch that high, it's pretty easy to lay off if you're the hitter.
Trouble averted here as this is tapped out in front of the mound. And a good throw gets him one gone. Next, it'll be Omar Narvaez, struck out in his first at bat. Bases are empty, one man out. The count is 2-2 to the Brewers catcher.
You have to find a way to lay off that low sinker. There is just no way to do any damage. You're just looking at either a bruised shin or a ground out to the left side.
Now a ball lined into left field. That's a base hit. And he will beat the throw into second as he slides in safely with a one out double.
Up next to Milwaukee, the third baseman, Eduardo.
To the plate now, Eduardo Escobar. And that one yanked just foul. Stroman comes set. Here's his offering. Slow roller out to short. Scooped up, and there are two away now. Stepping in next, Daniel Vogelbach. A couple of RBIs for him already, and a chance for more here.
And that was a great swing he put on that changeup last time up to hit that home run. Just an absolutely textbook job of letting it travel, keeping his hands back before exploding on it. Hey, he's done an amazing job of settling down. Two innings ago, I thought they were going to run him out of here. But now he's close to posting two shutout innings as a response.
3-2 pitch. Tip held on to behind the plate. Nice work there to get the punch out, and the inning is over. Digging in, the switch hitter, Jonathan Villar, 0-for-2 for him to this point. Now the 1-1 pitch. Misses, ball two. Check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. 2-2. this one off.
Obviously, he's not fatiguing whatsoever. Still in the mid to high 90s with his fastball. These guys got to stay on the attack if they're going to have a chance.
And here in just the fifth inning, this will be pitch number 100 here.
Boy, pitch count up near 100 right now, D-Row. And this is when you try to get to a good starting pitcher. Right now, it looks like he's running on fumes.
Yeah, the manager's got to get a couple people up in the bullpen right now. One ball hits the gap. They get runners in scoring position. This game could be out of commission.
Adrian Hauser, right-handed reliever, standing 6'3", gets the ball now out of the bullpen.
Hauser.
2-1. All even now, 2-2. Hits are now even at 4 apiece. Still 2-2. Swung on in the dirt, strike 3. Makes the throw to first, 2 down. Now with the plate is Francisco Lindor, a hit and 2 tries for him so far. 3-2 pitch. Bouncer to the left side. Throw in time, and the side is retired. Set now for the bottom of the fifth, and that'll bring forth the veteran outfielder, Lorenzo Cain. The 2-1 on its way. They really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out. Luis Urias steps into the on-deck circle now, looking to start something here with one gone in the inning. Now here's the pitch. Lofted in the air out toward right center. And that'll take care of the pinch hitter here for out number 2. So stepping in is Colton Wong. He bounced out last time up. 3-1 our score as we play inning number 5. Lifted the other way to left center. McNeil will reach out with one hand to make the catch on the move, and that ends the inning. Number 31 is ready, and he'll take the ball from the manager.
Number 31.
Top half of the sixth about to get started, and next to bat will be the first baseman, Pete Alonso. Here comes the 1-2. Is taken for ball 2. Two pitches fouled away. Here's the pitch. On the line, that's a base hit.
Up next to the bat, right fielder.
Into the box now, Michael Conforto. Hit the target, but this is low, 2-1. A little too tall that time. 3-1 now. Javier Baez, who represents the possible go-ahead run here, waits in the on-deck circle. And the count will be full. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. And it's fouled away. Payoff pitch one more time. And he looks at one that misses, and that's an excellent job of making his man throw a lot of pitches as he toughs down to the wall. Alonso on second. Conforto on at first with nobody out. Oh, they have him looking awfully confused up there right now. It's one and two.
Hey, don't kid yourself. I know those were two bad swings, but he hits middle of the order for a reason. It only takes one swing.
So he chased out of the strike zone on that one. Javier Baez goes down to become the first out in the sixth inning. Jeff McNeil will be his first assignment here as he'll face him with runners at first and second and one gone. Two balls and a strike.
When you've got a guy that throws a good two-seam fastball, you have to be ready for him to try to run it inside and jam you. Good job to lay off that one, but I wouldn't be surprised if we see it again.
That's in there. Base hit. And that'll plate the run from second as the lead shrinks to one at 3-2 now. Into the box, James McCann. Line to the right side. And that's in there. Base hit. Conforto is on his way home. Safe at the plate. We are knotted at three.
Now batting, the pitcher, Marcus.
In now, Marcus Stroman. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball.
A couple strikeouts early in the game, but he's done a much better job in this at bat, trying to get ahead and put himself in a good hitter's count.
To the left side, but it's well fouled. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. One there. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. Bottom of the sixth inning now. And coming forward now is the shortstop, Willy Adames. Fouled away. Now the 3-2 pitch. And that one misses, so the leadoff man will head down to first on ball four to start the bottom of the sixth. Into the box, Christian Yelich, who went down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
That's through, and he's got his first base hit. He's one for three. Trevor Williams comes on now in an awfully difficult situation as there are two on here with nobody out. So now to the plate, Avisail Garcia. Down the left field line and deep, but this will wind up being a foul ball. Swing and a ball hit out toward right center. Giving chase is Nimmo. He makes the catch, and tagging is the runner from second. And he'll get into third here on the flyout, so he's 90 feet away here with one gone. So now to the plate, Omar Narvaez. He's got runners at the corners here with only one gone. The 1-1 home. And he goes the other way as this is hit high and deep out to straightaway left. It'll die on the warning track as the catch is made. And here comes the runner from third. And that'll bring in the go-ahead run from third. It's now a 4-3 game.
Number five.
So it's a runner at first with two men out, and that'll bring up Eduardo Escobar. In the dirt, and it's not in time as he's in well ahead of the throw. And he'll make it into scoring position here with two away as that'll be scored a wild pitch. On the ground, a second for Baez. Throw to first beats him easily, and the side is retired. All set for the start of the inning, and next will be the switch hitting third baseman, Jonathan Villar. A ball and two strikes now. Yeah. Two balls and two strikes to Jonathan Villar. Here now the 2-2. Hit in the air down the right field line. And that will end up a foul ball. Another try at 2-2. High in the air into shallow left center. Here comes Yelich. He makes the catch. A great effort to get there and record the first out of the inning. So here's Brandon Nimmo. He went down on strikes last time up.
Yeah, but it was a good changeup, Matty. Good arm action on that pitch. Look for him to try and stay back a little bit more. Let the ball get a little deeper. Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to rush a heater right here.
Nimmo with an even count of 2-2 now.
Two balls, two strikes.
And a swing and a miss here, so it's a quick two outs to start the seventh. And now in the box, Francisco Lindor. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. And he'll come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now. A three-ball, one-strike count to the Mets shortstop.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
And he lays off ball four. So now the potential tying run here is aboard late in the game. Pete Alonso will be the first to greet him here as he stands in with a runner at first and two away. The 1-1.
Nope, that's down.
Swing and a miss there, and it's 2-2.
Not much you're going to do with that pitch right there. You have to catch it out front before it even breaks, and even if you do that, it's a tough pitch to keep fair.
A little late on the fastball, but he's able to spoil that one off, and he'll get another chance. The 2-2 one more time to short. And as it turns out, the two-out walk doesn't come around to haunt him as that ends the inning. Half of the seventh here, and here comes the first baseman, Daniel Vogelbach. Vogelbach behind the ball and two strikes.
Threw that fastball right by him. He had no chance to get the barrel to that one.
Left side, but well fouled. The next 1-2 pitch. High in the air out to center field. Waiting on it is Nimmo. One down. One away for the Brewers in their half of the seventh. And that'll bring up the center fielder, Lorenzo Cain. And a full count to Cain. Three balls and two strikes. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. Ranging back is Nimmo, but he has no chance to make the play. It's off the wall. And he is in at second base with a one-out double. James Peterson will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher. We're in the seventh inning now of a 4-3 ball game. Can't do much with that one. It's 1-2. Into center field, and that's going to get down for a base hit. Rounds the corner and is headed home. And he's safe at the plate as they extend their lead to 2.
Now back, second baseman, touchdown.
At the plate now, Colton Wong. Fastball taken inside for a ball. 2-1 now. Tried to crush that ball, but now perhaps needs to shorten up with two strikes. And he missed with this one up around the noggin. Now it's full.
We could see the runner in motion here on a 3-2 count with one out. There's a pretty good chance he's going to get a pitch to swing at, and if not, it's ball four anyways.
Hit hard down the line. And that's through for his first base hit in this one. And he'll move up to third now. Runners at the corners here with one away.
Now batter,
to the plate now, Willy Adames. Well below the knees, laid off on the changeup there.
It's not easy to continue pounding the strike zone when you've given up three consecutive hits, but he has to trust that getting the ball down in the zone will get him an out.
Brewers shortstop ahead with a 3-1 count. Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. And the good fastball there finds the zone as the count goes full now. 3-2. Popped him up. Baez calls for it. And he makes the catch for the second out. And now here is Christian Yelich, singled in his last at bat.
Christian Yelich.
Now the 1-1 pitch. Five runs, eight hits, one error thus far in the game for Milwaukee. Hit sharply on the ground. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Brent Suter has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 35.
Ready to begin the eighth, and up next, the left-handed hitting Michael Conforto. The 2-1. He missed with it here, so now it's a full count, 3-2.
Yeah, well, down two, you better believe they'd gladly take a leadoff walk right here. Anything to get a base runner on to get that tied run to the plate.
And he'll step on first himself to the out. Here's Javier Baez. Three at-bats for him in this one, all ending with him going down on strikes. And he'll strike out here yet again. It's been a ball game to forget thus far. Four strikeouts.
Number six.
So here's Jeff McNeil. They're quickly down to their final four outs here tonight. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. Three runs, seven hits, and no errors on the Mets line score so far. Swing and a miss got him reaching. And that ends the inning. It'll be the four-hole hitter, Avisail Garcia. A 1-1. Strike two swinging.
I got to count one.
Got
in
the chase after the curveball below the zone there. That was a really nice pitch, and it can be a really tough one to lay off of as a hitter.
And he wasn't going to hit that one with an or. The strikeout, and there's one gone.
Omar Garcia.
Now the 1-1 pitch. Hit out towards second. And that is through into center field for a one-out single.
The third baseman, number 5, Eduardo Escobar.
Standing in now, Eduardo Escobar. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone. Now Daniel Vogelbach's next.
Number 20.
Narvaez leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1.
Nope.
3-1.
Three balls, one strike.
The 3-1 pitch.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
Had to wait back on the changeup, and he did a good job just to make contact. Smoked on the ground up the middle, and that's in for a base hit. He's 2-for-4 now. Seth Lugo is in out of the bullpen now as he'll be inserted into the number 6 spot following the double switch. Luis Guillorme will also come on now as he'll move into the pitcher's number 9 hold in the order here on that double switch. Into the box now, Lorenzo Cain. Good battle, count remains full. Once again a 3-2. High in the air down the right field line. And that will end up a foul ball. The next 3-2. Popped him up. Alonso moving to his left. And the inning is over. Josh Hader comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth. Now into the box, James McCann singled home a run in his last time up.
Looking for base runners here as they're down 2 playing on the road. Not an easy thing to do, trying to score runs or bunch hits together off of a closer.
The count now at 2-1. Now here it comes.
3-1.
If you're at the plate in this situation, you're only thinking one thing, and that is get on base. You got 3 balls. It has to be perfect over those 17 inches for you to pull a trigger. A walk is as good as a knock right here.
And look out. That's in very tight, and it's ball 4. Next, it'll be Luis Guillorme. The 1-2. Misses for the second ball.
Man, this at bat has changed quickly from 0-2 now to 2-2. A good job of plate discipline by this hitter, not chasing those pitches just off the plate.
Skied in the air to straightaway left. Yelich is under it. One out. So the batting order turns over now and set to go Jonathan Villar. Struggling so far in this one and looking to erase his 0-for-4 ball game right here. Working for the punch out and the offering. And you can tell he wanted to hold off, but he swings through the inside pitch anyway, and he becomes out number 2. He's set, and the 2-1 pitch.
I always remember John Smoltz telling me, the greatest asset a closer can have is short-term memory. And this situation calls for it right here. He's got to forget that he has any traffic on a base pass and just attack the zone.
Throw on to first, and the ball game is over.
Hey, this was a pretty tightly played game. Got a little bit of everything in this one. Some timely hitting, runs on the board, key pitching, and defense in certain spots. This one was a fun one to watch.
5-3, the final score in this afternoon's game. The Milwaukee Brewers rode an important 6th inning to victory in this one. Aaron Ashby is credited with the win. So that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vaskirjan. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.
The final line score for our ball game this afternoon for the victorious Brewers, 5 runs, 10 hits, 1 error. They left 6 men on base. for the Mets. Three runs on seven hits. No errors. They left nine runners on base. Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 59 minutes.